Hi everyone! Today we're going to talk about how to use the graph of a function and the precise definition of the limit to find delta. To complete this problem, we'll identify the side of the limit that constrains the definition and then use that value of epsilon to find delta. Let's take a look. In this particular problem, we've been asked to use the graph of f of x equals the square root of x to find delta such that if the absolute value of x minus 4 is less than delta, then the absolute value of the square root of x minus 2 is less than 0.4. And you may notice that this problem is strongly related to the precise definition of the limit, or the epsilon delta definition of the limit, which I've written here for reference, which says that if 0 is less than the absolute value of x minus a, which is also less than delta, then the absolute value of f of x minus l is less than epsilon. With this problem, we've also been given the graph of our function y equals the square root of x, which we've drawn here in orange. And this graph is going to be really helpful to us because it's going to show us or give us a visual representation of what we're trying to find. Remember that with problems like this, we're usually asked to find one of two things. We're either asked to find delta or epsilon. If you have to find delta, you're usually given epsilon, and if you have to find epsilon, you're usually given delta. In this case, we've been given epsilon, right? We've been told that epsilon is equal to 0.4, and we can see that here. Epsilon, in the precise definition of the limit, in our problem is 0.4. And what that means is that we've been allowed to move a distance away from our y-coordinate here of 2, a distance of 0.4. So we have our y-coordinate here of 2, and we've been allowed to move 0.4 in this direction and 0.4 in this direction to get to 1.6 or 2.4. And each of these distances here we can call epsilon. This distance is equal to epsilon and this distance is equal to epsilon. They're both equal to 0.4. So what this problem is asking us to do is, given that constraint, given that epsilon has to be less than or equal to 0.4 and we have to stay within a distance of 0.4 in either direction away from 2, what it's asking us to do is say, how far away can we get from 4 and still stay within that range? So how far can we get away from 4, either this distance here or this distance here? How far can we get away from 4 and still stay within that range? Well, the interesting thing about this problem is that we can only define one value for delta, right? We can see that the distance from this line to 4 and the distance from this line to 4 are very different. And we can only define one value for delta. So the problem is, if we were to define this second distance here as delta, if we said that this was equal to delta, then that means that we would be allowing ourselves to move an equivalent distance to the left away from 4, right? Let's maybe say that would be about like this, the same distance. And that would throw us way outside of our epsilon range, right? Because if we could move all the way to this point here, then that would mean that we could move all the way down to here with epsilon. And we can't. We can't move lower than 1.6. So this line here really represents the farthest that we can move away from 4. So this distance right here has to define delta. And then the equivalent distance will say we can only move about this far to the right of 4 and we'll have to stay within this range here. That distance, that delta, will ensure that we stay within our epsilon range over here on the y-axis. So given that, that means that we are much more interested in this point here and how far that is away from x equals 4 than we are in this point. So we're going to try to figure out how far this point is away from the point x equals 4. Notice that that point corresponds to the y value of 1.6. So that's going to be the y value that we're interested in. Given that that's the y value that we're interested in, we can just go ahead and plug that straight into our function. We have the function f of x equals the square root of x, and we know that f of x, or y, is equal to 1.6. So we can plug 1.6 in for f of x and set that equal to the square root of x. Now we just want to solve for x. So we'll go ahead and square both sides.
When we take 1.6 times 1.6, or 1.6 squared, we get 2.56 equal to x. What this tells us is that the corresponding x value for a y value of 1.6 is x equal to 2.56. So this point right here is at 2.56. So now what we really need to know is the distance between 2.56 and 4, because that will give us our delta here. So we want to say 4 minus 2.56 to find the difference between the two. And when we do that arithmetic, we get 1.44. So what that tells us is that delta must be less than or equal to 1.44. If delta is less than or equal to 1.44, then what we're saying is that we will never move greater than 1.44 away from x equals 4, either to the left or to the right. And if we never move farther away from x equals 4 than 1.44, we will stay within this range here. We'll stay within this boundary and this boundary, and that guarantees that we'll stay within this boundary, 1.6, and up here within 2.4. If we had gone out to this line here, then we would have blown outside of our 1.66 epsilon boundary on the y-axis.
So I hope you found that video helpful. If you did, like this video down below and subscribe to be notified of future videos.